Okay, so now we're going to start. So dream with me. What I wanted to do is talk a little bit about the dream camera that we all have. Like, I want a camera that does everything, everything. So what would we want it to do? First of all, I love 4x5. I miss 4x5. This is where I'm checking to see if the jib guy's awake. So I love to do tilt shift swing with lenses. I miss doing that. I miss film. I miss all the different emulsions that we had ability to use. I'd like to be able to sync flash at any speed like I could when I used the old leaf shutter lenses and stuff. That was so cool before high-speed sync was even needed. And, you know, I love to be able to use different film stocks and get different effects and process differently, and I miss all that stuff. So I wish I could do that on a dream camera. Another thing I like is a really fast action camera. I like something that's going to turn on immediately and let me start shooting right away. I don't want to be waiting around for lights to blink and things to happen. I want the autofocus to acquire instantly, acquire and then track. I want really, really good high performance in autofocus. And I want a fast motor drive. The fastest motor drive in the DSLR range right now is the 1DX, the Canon 1DX at 12 frames a second, where it can still do autofocus. I want 14. Wouldn't that be cool to have a 14 frame per second motor drive? What else? I like German glass. The Krauts, man, they know how to make lenses. So Zeiss, Leica, something like that, it'd be really cool to have a whole complement of lenses, 24, 35, 50, 85, 135, 200. I'd like all that to be like, because they're so sharp. The German glass is so awesome. It's so worth the money for me. And also, I want a 2.8 lens. I don't want to have something that starts at 2.8 and ends at 5.6, or starts at 3.5 and ends at 6.3. I want 2.8 all the way through the range. Because it's just snappier that way, and the camera also does better in autofocus in a low light. I want great steady shot. If I'm doing stills or video, it doesn't matter. I want to be able to hand hold a 200 millimeter lens and really nail stuff. I don't want to use a tripod. I can't stand them. They get in my way, and they always bang my shins. I'd like the camera to be small enough to be put on a jib arm. If I want to do that, that would be nice to be able to fly it around and stuff for video assignments. I would definitely want 4K internal capture, which is coming for everybody, but only a few companies have 4K internal capture in their cameras right now. I really want that feature because it's the best possible quality you can get. I want it reasonably priced, and I want reasonably priced batteries for it because you always have to have extra batteries in whatever you're doing. And then last, I want an internal neutral density filtration system. So if I want to go out and shoot outside on the side of a glacier at noon and I want to shoot at 2.8, I can do that. That would be really cool. All right, more video options. I want a great codec that's universally readable by any software. That's very important to me. I want to be able to ingest the clips into any software, any computer, and have them immediately be viewable. Because I like to edit sometimes before I even go into the video editor. I want to get rid of all the junk before I start the real process. And I want lots of options in speed. So if I want it 24p and things aren't moving real fast, it's an interview and I can do the real eye candy kind of wide, you know, wide open lens, that's cool. But then I want to go to 30p and maybe even 60 frames a second and all the way to 120 native in full HD. And then I do want to do what my iPhone can do already, which is super slow-mo. I'd love to go 960 frames a second and not have to rent a Phantom for, you know, $8,000 a day. That'd be really nice. I want an onboard mic option that gives Phantom power so I can use a real microphone like this one. I want real audio options, not plug-in and little rubber bands holding things together. I want, like, serious, serious high-end audio capability to be able to plug into this camera. So I want two XLR mic inputs that go right into the camera without needing to fool the firmware or jump start things or buy black boxes that attach. I just want a straight up, straight into the camera option for audio. I want a great shotgun mic that sits on top of that thing and really gives me good results when I want to do a shotgun. And I want a built-in decent stereo mic too, something that when the cars go from my left to the right, you actually hear it go from the left to the right instead of just coming and going. Now, in viewing, I want to really be able to see on the back of the camera a good quality image so I can really judge what I'm doing and if it's working or not. I want zebra and I want focus peaking just in the pro high-end video cameras that Sony, Panasonic, Ikigami have. I want a second really, really high definition display where I can really judge critical sharp focus and I can get good information, real information about my exposure so I'm not blowing something when I think I'm okay because I can't see the viewfinder. I want an HDMI out for being able to use multi-monitors, like for a client monitor at a shoot. That's very common these days, and people ask me that all the time. I want the thing to be super low-light capable. I want to be able to go in without a flash, without lights, and really capture great imagery without hassle because the chip is so good. I want a near-silent shutter or a totally silent shutter, either one. And I want that 14 frames a second. And when I shoot at 14 frames a second, I want that quiet too. So if I'm going to shoot the golf swing at a PGA tournament on the tee box, I'm not getting hauled off to the parking lot by a bunch of security guards. And I want to be able to see in the dark. When I can no longer see to focus in real light with my eyes, I want the camera to actually be able to focus even though it's so dark I can barely see. The chip, this dream camera, I would want to not be a little tiny chip that's the size or smaller than my pinky fingernail. I want a really good chip that will allow me to kind of throw things out of focus in the background to be able to clean things up. I want this camera system to match up really well with other high-end professional camera lenses and camera systems so that there's not a big hiccup when I'm trying to pull footage from this camera system into something from a more cinematic field. So I want to just have a really good situation where I can use whatever I want and it doesn't cost me days and days to try to color match it later in post. I want easy toning in still photography and easy color grading after the fact. And I don't want the footage to look obviously bad. Sometimes you pull GoPro footage in with other stuff and it just doesn't hold up. Synergy. I want it to look and feel and act the same for me whether I'm shooting video or whether I'm shooting stills. I want the same camera, the same controls, everything to be identical. I don't want to reinvent the whole camera with bolting stuff onto it and attaching things and having wires all coming out of it. I want it really simple, straightforward, and totally functional. I want a true convergence tool. That's what I'm after. I want it to be easy enough to use where I can give it to my mom, who always cuts my head off when I have a her take a picture of me. I want it to be able to be given to an assistant who normally does lighting, but that I could do on a second camera shoot. I could just say, hey, can you shoot a little bit of footage with this? I want that to work. And I want to be able to customize the buttons and the custom functions to match all my other cameras so that no matter which one I pick up, they're all the same every single time I use them. I want it to be social media friendly. I want to be able to push out. I want to be able to shoot an image and then immediately push out a great photograph onto Instagram or put it on my Facebook page or tweet it. I want to be able to do that even with video clips. I want instant publishing without downloading cards or going to find a laptop or power or wireless. I want to do it all through my phone. I don't want the wedding party looking at the back of my camera anymore. It's a waste of time, and I'm missing pictures while they're doing that. I would rather have them be glued to their phone, seeing my feed as I'm progressing throughout the wedding day. That is the way to go. Small. I want something small and lightweight. I want to have all those lenses, all those German lenses, and all those focal lengths. I want to have a microphone solution, extra batteries, and I want all that to weigh less than 4 pounds. And you might be thinking it might take NASA 10 years to make this kind of thing, right? I want to be able to carry it all day long and not have to get an Aleve or a Motrin sponsorship because, man, I tell you, I'm 5'0 now, and I feel the pain at the end of these long shoot days. I want it really inexpensive because I don't have a lot of money. I'm a photographer. I'm trying to make a living, paying the mortgage and stuff. I want to have a couple of these things if I can afford it. So I'd love to spend a ridiculously low price to get a system like this with all these attributes and possibilities. Maybe $5,000. I know that's pushing it. How about $1,298? The camera I just described to you is not a dream, it's a reality. You can go play with them right over the Sony counter. The Sony RX10 II is probably the least publicized camera. It's like the little camera that could, but nobody like pays attention to it. It's all about the A7 series, which is awesome, don't get me wrong, but for the money, if you're trying to figure out if mirrorless is for you, there is no better way to enter into mirrorless photography than through this camera, which is so unbelievably capable. This is the little audio unit that goes on the top. It's $600 for that. So the combination of the camera and the audio unit, which comes with a microphone, you're under $2,000 for something that is just an absolute amazing tool. I think we're going to skip that. And you know what? They got it working. So just kind of a quick overview of some of the high points, not all of them, but some of them. The RX10 II has a Zeiss 24 to 200 millimeter 2.8 lens that is a static constant aperture. It doesn't change as you zoom as so often they do. It allows for internal 4K capture. You can actually pull still images right off of the video frames if you need it. They're roughly equivalent to a 10 megapixel file. So you can like roll video in 4K and then stop right where you want to and then do a frame grab and pull that into Photoshop or Lightroom and tone it as you would a normal file from a digital camera. It's an amazing thing to be able to do this. It has a true 14 frame per second motor drive. And remember, because there's no mirror flapping up and down, the camera does not have to do predictive autofocus like Canon and Nikon. It is seeing at all times what you are seeing in the EVF, in the viewfinder. It sees everything that you see always without obstruction of a mirror flopping. So the autofocus performance is awesome. It has a built-in onboard stereo mic, the XLR unit we talked about, and there's this really cool Bluetooth mic system that I use a lot in high ambient noise situations like this that is like under $200, and it is the coolest thing. It even has a on the aperture ring, there's a D-click switch. You just throw a switch, and now it's smooth. So if you're doing video, you can just do really smooth transitions of you going from inside of a building outside, and you need to do that without the click, 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 and the big chunk. You don't want all that chunkiness in your changes. One of the things that people don't get about mirrorless, which is a bummer, is they think that mirrorless is like the back of the camera that they have now. So the pro cameras from Nikon and Canon, the back of the camera has about 800,000 pixels to look at. And that's what you're looking at when you zoom in and trying to see if something's sharp or see if it's right or if you got the picture. Well, when you look inside of the viewfinder through the eyepiece of a Sony EVF, it's either 2.4 or 2.8 million pixels. So ask yourself this question. When you go home tonight and you want to watch TV, are you going to watch standard definition TV, or are you going to watch HD, or are you going to watch 4K? And if you had the choice, which one would you prefer? The answer is pretty obvious. So please don't make your judgment about mirrorless based on what the back of your current camera looks like when you look at the back display. It is not like that. It's super sharp and really nice. And the last thing about this camera, there's a lot of things, but I had to cut it off somewhere. There's a very, very good steady shot system in it. Now, I will tell you, I'm pretty good at hand-holding at very low shutter speeds. I'm decent at that. I do a good job. I can hand-hold the RX10 all the way zoomed out to 200 millimeter at eighth of a second and have about 75% chance of getting a sharp picture. So if I take 10 pictures, I'm going to get seven of them. Seven of them are going to be tack. But if you're not that steady, the steady shot feature is really, really cool. And it often means that it's so good that you don't need a tripod for a lot of video production. It's really amazing. So $1,298, it's quite a deal. And finally, you know, the Sony RX10 II, it seeks to set you free, to get rid of all the weight that you're carrying around, the backpack, maybe you're doing rolling cart everywhere you go. The RX10 gives you this option that is so lightweight and so nimble. It can set you free technically to just worry about the content, worry about the interview you're doing, worry about only the photography that you're doing and nothing else. You're not sore, you're not hurting, you're not in pain. It's pretty sweet. You can carry it all day and not even know it's there. And that freedom from all the hassle of a DSLR it really makes shooting fun again. And it makes me want to go out and shoot instead of just going home and watching TV. I think because we have the time and they figured out whatever the problem was, we're going to go ahead and go back a few. And what I did is when I first got the original RX-10, now this footage we're going to show you in these pictures are not from the RX-10 Mark II, which is much better than the original RX-10. But when I got the thing, I had a friend of mine call me, and he had an assistant that was supposed to double shoot a wedding with him. And he had told the people that he was going to have two shooters there, and he called me desperate. He's like, Pat, can you help me out? Can you just come and double shoot this for me? And I said, sure, but I'm not carrying all that stuff. He wasn't paying much. He's my buddy, right? I said, I'm going to bring the RX-10 and see how it does. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a little video that I made at someone else's wedding. So let's pull the lights down, please. So it's literally just press a button in your shooting video, press the other button in your shooting stills. You can get real moments like that easily. It does great with macro. It goes really close. The lens is phenomenal. I don't know why more people aren't interested in this camera. It's really something. It also doesn't look like a big scary thing to little kids. So this is handheld, no monopod, no tripod, just me. There's the still photographer dragging all the heavy stuff in the background in that shot. Notice the out-of-focus backgrounds. A lot of people don't like a 1-inch chip. They say it's not as good as full frame, and they're right. But man, it does a really nice job knocking things out of focus. Once again, it's great to be able to just shoot a still picture and then go, you know, this would make a nice video clip. I think I'll do that. And then here's the still from the same exact moment. This is a leaf shutter. I couldn't have done this with a DSLR because it wouldn't sync flash at a 1500th of a second. All right, and the rest is just to kind of a lead out. You guys in the back can pull it down to nothing, bring the lights back up. The path to mirrorless for me was an interesting one. It did not happen in the way that it has for many people. For me, I was looking for a solution for a big problem that I had that a client asked me to do. This client asked me to do a video shoot, and they described a shot that I could not do. I didn't have the ability to do it technically. I didn't have the experience. And they certainly didn't have the budget to make it work how I know Hollywood would have done it. And I went home and I did a Google search for facial recognition autofocus because I knew that was the only thing that would make this work. And lo and behold, I found the Sony A99. And I bought a 20mm lens and I did some testing with my son in my garage. And I called the client back and said, you know what? I can do that shot. And it's not going to cost $1 million. That was my entry into Sony. When the A7 came out, it was nothing short of a miracle. I'd never seen a camera, a full-frame camera, that produced such awesome images, that was so tiny and lightweight. I knew that this was the system that I needed, that I'd been waiting for so long. The coolest thing about Sony for me as a working pro these last 25 years is that they come up with things on a regular basis that I didn't even ask them for. Like, I don't have the imagination they do, and they deliver these new products, and they hand them to us and say, here, we did some things in engineering. Check this out. See what you think. And it's just mind-boggling, the things that they're able to do. And the frequency at which they come out with new products and replace great cameras with better ones is shocking. I mean, I'm used to the old, you know, Nikon and Canon, where it's like every 10 years you get a new pro body. Now it's like every 7 or 6. Sony is waiting, that, but every 6 to 9 months, they're coming out with another product that's revolutionary. So I really, it's really good to be thinking about this. And again, in the big picture of the 10,000 foot view, if you're not shooting mirrorless with somebody's camera, you need to think about it, because it is not an option. I think it's the way all cameras are going to be made very shortly. A lot of people just haven't figured that out yet. So I'm going to leave now with 2 minutes left, because I'm the man and I don't go over. All right. You've been very good to come back from break and give me your patience and stuff and your attention. I really appreciate it. I will be around at the Sony booth from today when I'm not speaking across the street. I go over there at like 2 o'clock today to do one of those reframe talks. I would invite you to come and find me there if you want to hear some more. My name is Patrick Murphy-Racey. If you want to know more about my work, just go to pmrphoto.com. I have a very active blog where I talk a lot about technical geeky stuff. And occasionally other things too. Thank you very much. I appreciate your attention.